Lewis.
Hey, Jeff. You there? I'm here. It's good
to see you after all these years.
It's all, boy. I believe that it goes fast. It goes like a shot. But the best part of it is me getting to see you again.
Hey, no, the best part of it is just being here to be seen.
You got that right.
Kunta, you have been a very good boy. I want you to know that. A very good boy.
It's like a roll call of some of the greatest actors that have ever lived.
Sicily.
Matt St. Clair.
Maya.
Maya Angelou. Vic Morrow.
Yeah, that was a good friend of mine. And then, of course, LeVar. LeVar really amazed me.
Get on up in there. No.
I think LeVar amazed everyone because it was, as far as I know, it was his initial role, certainly his initial principal role in any project, and he came through like a veteran champion.
Musta say, you name Toby. Hey, what's the matter with you? Turn me loose.
Kunta Kinte.
Then Leslie Uggams, who was outstanding in the thing.
I promise you, Daddy, your dream will not die. Someday, we're gonna be free.
I'd fallen in love with her, as did the rest of the country, as a result of her appearances on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Absolutely.
And I never thought as a child growing up that I would have a chance to work with any of these people.
Fiddler, he's a runaway.
Lorne Greene, really my master.
You feel me, Fiddler? And what we'll do about that, we'll discuss at a later time.
What a professional. What a professional he was.
Yes.
Benjamin Green, Chicken George.
Ready? How's free?
George! Robert Reed. He had quite a load that he had to carry for us to get into that series.
If any of you break the rules, my rules, I have no choice but to remove the offender for the good of all the rest of us.
And he took it, and he did it beautifully. Kunta Kinte and Fiddler did not really know about freedom. He kept on looking at this kid, wanting to escape, time in, time out, time in, time out.
Don't you care what that white man call you? Make you say Toby. What you care?
I remember the sign, what's it like to be free? I remember that close-up. What is it like to be free? Because Fiddler didn't really realize what freedom really meant to that kid. He would rather die than be a slave.
There's gonna be another day. You hear me? There's gonna be another day.
It probably was good for me, too, because I found myself fitting in, if you want to know that. And it's not fitting in. It's freedom. It's the freedom that I believe in, the freedom of an animal, freedom of a lion, a tiger. It's a freedom. And the absolute epitome of that freedom he got from Kunta Kinte.
Now you know how it feels to be free, Fiddler. Now you know what I'm always talking about.
I've been blessed because Roots gave me a chance to refute all the negative stereotypes that have been perpetuated in my education and in society and in the world at large.
You're not Kunta Kinte, you're Toby, and you belong to me, and I belong to you.
And we both belong to Dr. Reynolds.
It gave me a chance to refute that in a way that they could understand, relate to, and become appalled by what we had gone through as a race of people.
Heave away, bosun!
So I'm grateful for the opportunities that were provided to me and all the wonderful, wonderful actors and writers and artists that I've worked with over the course of my career, all of whom have contributed towards not just me having a successful career, but providing a global audience with entertainment that is also educational. When Roots aired, we all wanted to see it because at that time, there was no means or no technical means of showing something that had been shown already. You couldn't recall it, tape it or whatever, at least not prevalent enough for me to have access to one. So the bottom line was, I made up a little fib. I was working on a show with Mr. Ernest Borgnine, an iconic actor. And I said, man, I really want to watch Roots. So I said, I'm going to have to beg off. I'm not feeling too well. I'm going to stay home tomorrow. And he said, I know why the kid's staying home. The kid wants to watch himself on Roots. So that's the impact it had on me and threatened to end my career because I was canceling out on Ernest Borgnine, an Academy Award winner. I'd accomplished something as an artist, as an African-American, and it made me feel like I had done what God intended me to do. So we had incredible talent in front of that camera, but the main talents I felt were those that put the words on that blank paper.
Were you not sent to catch a bird? Did you forget the instructions given you?
I did not forget.
And you decided it would be better to disobey those instructions and...
I saw white men.
It's a story of humanity.
Yeah. And the Kunta Kinte and how their relationship evolved from boy to man. And God got a chance to see LeVar grow into a John Amos. All right. Thank you, sir. I love you. And I can't wait to see you again.
Back at you, Mr. Gossett.
All right. Peace, everybody.